Hey everybody, Clay Archer, CEO, DPC Technology. I've got a cool one today. Today we're going to review the new UniFi Pro XG 8 PoE Switch. So UniFi's come out with a bunch of 8-port PoE switches lately, and I've been a big fan of all of them, and I've traditionally been a user of the Enterprise 8 PoE Switch. So today I'm going to kind of go through what's new about the new Pro XG 8 PoE and how it stacks up to those other switches. And I'm going to go over a bunch of use cases where I think this might be a good fit. So this comes in the typical UniFi packaging, really nicely done. Inside the box, you'll find a wall mount for both the switch itself and the power adapter. This switch uses the AC adapter, 210 watt. This is the same adapter that's on the Pro Max 16 PoE and the Flex 2.5 8 PoE switch. This adapter does provide a ton of power, but it is a bigger brick. So keep that in mind for your use case. And like I said, it does come with a wall mount for that adapter, which is nice. You'll see on the front of the unit, it has 8 10 gigabit PoE plus ports. And those are backward compatible with 10 gig, 5 gig, 2.5 gig, 1 gig. And 100 megabits, and it has 2 10 gig SFP plus ports. On the front, it also has a system reset button and a system LED. It does not have the traditional UniFi LCD on the front. On the back, there's just the single barrel style power input. So other than that, there's the typical mounting hardware and leveling template in the packaging. So next, let's jump into store.ui.com, and I'm going to compare it to the other 8-port switches that I think are appropriate to compare it to. So I'm going to choose the Pro XG 8 PoE and I'm going to click compare. And for me personally, I most closely compare it to the Enterprise 8 PoE. So I'll click compare there. And I'm a big fan of the Flex 2.5 gig PoE. So I'm going to go ahead and click compare on that. I'm not going to compare it because I don't think it's really comparable, but this is another switch I think you might replace with this switch, which is the USW Flex XG, the Flex 10 gigabit. This is an awesome switch. I've been using it for years. It gives you 4 10 gigabit ports. This has kind of been my gateway switch into 10 gigabit networking. And I think at $299, it's a really awesome option. So if you're looking for inexpensive 10 gigabit networking and don't need PoE, it's a really cool option. But I'm going to go ahead and click compare on these three. The Pro XG 8 PoE comes at $499, which is $20 more than the Enterprise 8 PoE. I've been running the Enterprise 8 PoE for a long time. When they came out with the 2.5 gigabit WAPs, it was a really good option to run those without having to put injectors on it. So I bought one maybe a year and a half ago, and I've been running it ever since. And the Flex 2.5 gigabit PoE is an awesome switch to put around. I call it like a field switch where you want to power it with PoE, and for $199, just add 8 ports. It's a really great switch, and you can check out my review for it. And I've also done a review of the Enterprise 8 PoE switch before, so you can check those out. Let's go down through the things that are different between the Pro XG 8 PoE and the Enterprise 8 PoE. First of all, the dimensions are a little different. I mentioned on Facebook and Reddit that the new Pro XG 8 PoE fits perfectly in a 10-inch rack. The Enterprise 8 PoE does not fit perfectly in a 10-inch rack. So that's the first thing right off the bat, is the dimensions a little bit narrower on the Pro XG 8 PoE than the Enterprise 8 PoE. And I chalk that up for not having that LCD screen on the front. So that's our first difference there. And the major difference is going to be the speed and power delivery on the ports. All 8 of this ports on the XG 8 PoE are 10 gig and PoE plus. And on the Enterprise 8 PoE, they're all PoE plus and 2.5 gig. So that's a big differential there on, you know, for $20 more, you're getting all PoE plus and 10 gig. You can see here the total power availability is 155 watts versus 120. The interesting thing about the Flex 2.8 PoE is the way you're able to power it. You can power it with PoE input. I would probably use a Flex 2.5 PoE powered by the Pro XG 8 PoE, meaning that its PoE plus power would be able to power it at 46 watts or PoE plus. The cool thing about the Flex 2.5 PoE is the flexibility. Obviously, it's in the name. You can power it with PoE in, or you can use that same 210 watt AC power adapter to power devices directly. So really cool flexibility of that device. Obviously, it's only 2.5 gigabits, but this is really a sweet spot. You know, for $199, the flexibility of it is pretty incredible. And so if you wanted to put the 210 watt AC adapter on it, that adapter is $79. So you're talking about $280 to have a 2.5 gig PoE plus switch with the power delivery of the Pro XG 8 PoE. Ish. That's not necessarily comparing apples to apples, but it's pretty close. And so if you're looking for that, that is an option. And you can see with these performance figures just how much more powerful the Pro XG is than the Enterprise, and in obviously more than the Flex. The other thing is the Pro XG 8 PoE and the Enterprise 8 PoE are layer 3 switches, where the 2.5 is a layer 2 switch. So you can check out those features or anything there makes a difference to you and what you're trying to do. The Enterprise 8 PoE build quality is really impressive. It's metal. It's got heat dissipating fins built into the case. It's a very heavy unit, as well as the Pro XG 8 PoE. It does not have the fins built into it, but it is a really heavy, kind of hefty device. Very robust. Whereas the Flex 2.5 PoE does not have that same kind of heft to it and kind of like overbuilt feeling to it. Not that it's, you know, cheap in any way. It just is. It doesn't have the same build quality as these, you know, for $500 switches do. With that, I'll jump into the software real quick. This adopts the same way that most UniFi hardware does at this point, where it auto detects it. You just click adopt, and it walks you through the process of adopting it. It updates the firmware, and it gets it adopted into UniFi network. That process probably took 3 or 4 minutes. I'll play some B-roll of it so you can see what that looks like. But it is now adopted into my infrastructure. So you can see it will show you what's connected, what the connection speed is to those connections. I've got a bunch of 10 gig stuff connected at this point. A UNAS connected to the SFP Plus port. I've got several things connected at 10 gig, something at 2.5 gig, and something at 1 gigabit. You can see that it's my desktop's got a couple connections there. So you can see I've got my desktop connected to it with a couple of ports. I've got my Super Micro. That is the iDRAC controller on my HL15. The two TrueNAS devices are the two NICs on my HL15. I've got a USW Enterprise 8 XG24. That's my normal switch that is connected in. And I've got my UNAS Pro Home, like I said, on SPF. You can go into Port Manager. It will give you more information on all of those ports, little icons. More details about each one of those devices. Pretty good stuff. You can there go into SATs. You can go into VLANs. I do not have any VLANs set up at this point, but you could go ahead and do that there. Pretty simple stuff. I do like that port manager. I spend quite a bit of time in there. I think it's a good way to look at what's connected in if you're having any issues or you're setting things up. So we'll go in here to history. This is just going to show you, when you've done firmware upgrades and whatnot. I can also go down to system statistics, see CPU usage and memory. And I can go back at different time frames on there. We've only had it on there for a couple of days, so you'll see not much there. And then we can go in here and set this up. I could give it a unique name. I could change colors. One other thing I didn't mention in that comparison chart is that this does have the Ether lighting, and the Enterprise 8 PoE does not have Ethernet lighting, which is a really nice feature. I do really like Ethernet lighting. And honestly, for me, I probably would rather have Ether lighting than the LCD port. But, you know, that's just a personal taste. And some people are different on that. So anyways, I could do network or I could do speed there. I just have it on default there in speed. You can change brightness. And then under manage, you can turn it on and off the LED on the front of it. You can do replacement device. You can load configuration, manually update your firmware, you locate, restart, and remove. All basic stuff that if you've seen a UniFi switch, you're going to be pretty used to all of that. So going through that, what are some use cases for this device? First of all, this would make an excellent home lab switch. I mentioned before the 10-inch rack. I'll show some pictures of this device in the 10-inch rack. I'm debating going to a 10-inch rack from my full rack here in my home. In my office, this rack does take up a lot of space. And if I go to a 10-inch rack, consume less power, consume a whole heck of a lot less space, it may work well for me in my existing office. So that's something I'm considering. I'm not sure I'm going to do that yet because having a full-size rack does let me test things, being able to put things in and out of the rack that are full-size easier than a 10-inch rack would. But if you don't have those needs, I do think for a home labber, the 10-inch rack is a compelling option now because you can do quite a bit of things with it. I'm a perfect example for another use case as well. My house was wired many years ago, and I don't have a ton of wiring in my house. So I have these little clusters of equipment. So my internet comes in across the house where my Flex is, and then I wired everything to a central location, and my home lab is in my office. I have the Enterprise 8 PoE and a couple of WAPs in the central location where all the wiring comes in. And then I have the bulk of my network in this office where I have my rack. Most people in a home have a similar setup where, you know, you have a DMARC somewhere in the house, but maybe you're doing most of your work in your office and you want to have several devices there. I think this is a great way to kind of do this where I've got the Enterprise 8 PoE in a spot, and then I've got another one of these over here. Even better than that is to have the Pro XG 8 PoE in a centralized spot and then put those Flex 2.5 gig 8 PoEs in different locations and not even have to have power to them, have them be powered off that centralized location. That's a really powerful use case. Having 10 gig PoE++ on every port may be a bit of overkill, but it's also really nice because you don't ever have to guess. You can just plug things in there. So it makes it perfect for like a test rig. For us, we do test benches where we are testing a bunch of machines, and the ability just to plug things in and have it auto-negotiate to do the best it can is awesome. So if you plug in something that has a 2.5 gig NIC, it will just auto-negotiate to that. Or if you have something that needs PoE plus power or plus plus power, you're able just to deliver that without having any issues and just turning it on. Another great use for it is a remote office where you don't have a ton of switching that you need to do, but you want everything to have a bunch of power and speed. I can also see this in a room where you have a bunch of engineers or VIPs where you want to have that power. This particular unit is going to go to Michael, my editor. He's going to have a UNAS and several Macs that are editing, and he wants to be able to edit video off of the UNAS. That's the perfect use case for this switch, where you're going to have a small work group of four or five machines that you want to connect 10 gig to a UNAS and have everything be able to be just screaming fast. It's a perfect use case for that. And if he needs to add anything like a WAP or anything that needs PoE and the high-speed connections, he'll have the ability to do that without thinking about it. And that brings up my last use case. If you're going to do a UniFi Protect deployment where you're going to have eight cameras or less, and you want them all to be able to power the cameras, this is a perfect switch to do that and to have a ton of overhead. And if you wanted to power a WAP or a Flex switch or anything else that needs PoE++ or less, you're good to go there. So those are the use cases I can think of off the top of my head for the switch. I think it's a really powerful switch. It's not an inexpensive switch, but you're getting a ton of features at a form factor that I think is attractive for most. And when you compare it to the Enterprise 8 PoE switch, I think this is a downright steal. So what do you think about the Pro XG 8 PoE? Leave your questions and comments down below. As always, please like and subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next video.